हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर डिस्कशन अबाउट एसी जनरेटर। सो व्हाट इज एसी जनरेटर? एसी जनरेटर आर एसी डायनमो और अल्टरनेटर इज अ डिवाइस विच कन्वर्ट्स मैकेनिकल एनर्जी इनटू इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। सो लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट इज द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक जनरेटर। AC generator is based on the electromagnetic induction and you know well about electromagnetic induction. Now, how the AC generator will form? What is the construction of AC generator? So, to construct AC generator, we have two magnets, field magnets with N and S pole. You are seeing that in this figure. There is S pole of the magnet and there is a N pole of the magnet, and this N south pole of this magnet is lying just backside of it, and the north pole of this magnet is lying just backside of it, and there is a armature of the AC generator, and this armature contains different number of turn over on it, and suppose that this corner is known as P, this one is the Q, and this one is R, and this one is S. So P, Q, R, S is a rectangular coil which form a armature of the AC generator, and the wire coming from this winding on the armature is connecting split rings, okay, R1 and R2. One turn is connected, one wire is connected to R1 and other wire is connected to R2, and these slip rings connected by a bus. This one is B1 and this one is B2, and this bus is connected to this slip rings. It means when rings rotated, then bus is connected and slips over this, okay. And all these two buses are connected via load, okay. So this is a simple construction of the AC generator. Now how generator works? So let us come to the working of the generator. As we know that when this armature rotates, and this armature is lying in this position, that PQ, this line PQ is going downward direction and this RS is coming on upward direction. It means this is going down and this one coming up. If this PQ is going downward and this RS part of the armature is coming upward to the plane of this board, then there is a induced EMF across the terminal of the coil, and hence because they are connected to a load, so there is a current flowing through the coil, and the direction of the current is lying as from P, Q, R, S, B2, R2, B2, then from load to B1, R1 and then P. So direction of the current in first time when PQ is going downward, PQ going downward and RS is going upward, direction of the current or the path by which the current flows is P to Q, then RS, then R2, then B2, then load, it means from load to B1 and R1, then P. So this is the path by which the current flows throughout the loop. Now when this loop rotates just half of it, and this makes its another position in which this PQ assumes as to be coming upward direction, and this RS goes at this side and assumes as to be going in downward direction. So when after half rotation PQ is going upward and RS is coming downward, then the direction of the current acquires a path P R1 B1 P R1 B1, then load, then B2 R2, then S and R Q R Q 2P. Okay, so we are seeing that in this way the direction of the current reverses its polarity. It means in this time, at this time, the direction of current is flowing through the load from B1 to B2, but in first case the current is going from B2 to B1. So we can observe that the current flowing through this load is reverses with respect to time. So such type of current which passes through any load, that is known as alternating current. So such we can explain it that AC generator produces AC currents. Okay, now let us come to the mathematical discussion, that is the theory of the AC generator. Okay, so let us start the theory. As we know that the total flux passing through the coil of this armature of the AC generator is given by a formula N into B into A. If the area of the coil makes an angle theta with the direction of the magnetic field possessed by the magnetic substance, so the total magnetic flux at that time will be represented by NBA cos of phi, cos of theta, NBA cos of theta. Now as we know that if the angular speed of this armature about this axis is omega, then the theta can be expressed as omega dot t. Okay, so at an instant of time t, if at t equal to 0, theta is 0, so theta can be expressed in terms of t, that is omega t. So flux can be explained in terms of omega t like this, NBA cos of omega t. So if we differentiate it with respect to time, then we get d phi by dt is equal to NBA, and differentiation of cos omega t, that is minus of sine omega t, and differentiation of omega t, that is omega. So this is the, if we take this minus at here, then we get minus omega NBA sine of omega t. As we know that the EMF induced at the terminal of the coil can be expressed as minus of d phi b by dt. So if you put the value of this d phi by dt from here, then this minus and this minus becomes positive. So we get omega NBA sine of omega t. So we get a formula for the induced EMF across the terminal of the coil, and we get the E equal to omega into NBA sine of omega t. We are seeing that this omega NBA are constant for any given particular AC generator and its armature and number of fixed turn coil and fixed number of turn. So this term can be expressed as the maximum EMF. So this can be expressed as E naught or EM sine of omega t. Okay, so if we plot a graph for this E, it means induced EMF with respect to time, then we get this is induced EMF, induced EMF, and this one is time. So suppose that this is the maximum EMF E naught, and this one is the minus of E naught. Then if we plot a graph for this, then we get, suppose that for plotting this, we can take a table at here, as we know that equal to E naught sine omega t can be expressed as E naught sine omega means 2 pi by t dot t. So if we take this t in terms of capital T like this, if you take t equal to t by 4, then omega t is equal to, then omega t is equal to t by 4, t and t cancel, and 4 it means pi by 2. And if you take this is as t by 2, then we get omega t as pi, and if we get it as 3t by 4, then this becomes 3 pi by 2, and if you take this as t, then we get 2 pi. Okay, similarly if we increase it as 5t by 4, then we get 5 pi by 2. Okay, 3t by 2, then we get it as 3 pi. Okay, similarly if we put at here 7t by 4, then we get 7 pi by 2. Okay, so if you put the value of this pi by 2 as an argument of this sign, then we get what will be the value of this sine omega t. Value of the sine omega t is, as we put this as pi by 2, then we get 1. Sine omega t becomes 1. For pi this is 0, for this minus 1, again this 0, this 1, and this 1 0, then minus 1. Okay, so we get this alternating value, and if we put t equal to 0, then we get this is 0. For if you put t is equal to 0, then this becomes 0, so equal to 0. And if you take this as t by 4, this one is t by 2, and this one is 3t by 4, this one is as t, this one is as 5t by 4, and this one is as 3t by 2, this one is as 7t by 4. Okay, so and next again you can write it as 2t. So what will be the value of this? You can draw a particular graph for this like this. At t equal to 0, the value of is 0, but when t becomes t by 4, then the value of this e becomes e naught, because this becomes 1, so this becomes e naught. So we can plot this like this. And when again at t by 2 this becomes pi, so sine of pi becomes 0, so it returns and provides us a value of 0 degree, 0 emf. Okay, so again if we plot it in forward direction, then we get in like this a particular graph. Okay, so you can check this with the help of this table. You can draw a particular graph for the induced EMF with respect to the time for a given AC generator. You are seeing that the polarity of this induced EMF is continuously changes with respect to time, so we can also say that the current produces due to this induced EMF is always changes its polarity with respect to time. So the direction of current is always in the direction of the induced EMF. It means the induced current is always in the direction of the induced EMF. It means the phase of the induced current and induced EMF is always in same direction. Okay, that is the phase of induced EMF and the induced current is same. Okay, so this is all about the AC generator. You can plot, you can make a particular figure for the understand the construction of working and also the theory. You can easily describe it. Now, theoretically, this chapter is finished. Tomorrow we will start our new chapter. But before starting new chapter, we will solve different types of numerical problems based on the electromagnetic induction phenomena. Okay, till now, take care. Thank you.